Thank you for joining us on another installment of Frost & Sullivan's exciting podcast series. I am Rishikesh Dhatrak, research analyst from the Visionary Science Group. I track the PPE market and also track the best practices in the industry. Today we will be discussing about the Western Europe respiratory protection market. With sectors such as manufacturing and construction showing signs of recovery, PAPO manufacturers will have the potential to shift users to a higher level of protection if they work on both portability and easy use of the equipment. Mergers and acquisitions are expected to continue being a way for companies to expand their presence in the mature market. However, the strategic imperative for a manufacturer to do this might just be limited to the respiratory protection sector, but also other allied PPE sectors. Distribution is the biggest sales channel for manufacturers. Therefore, securing the right partnerships across regions will be important for manufacturers to increase their presence. This will be especially relevant for a new PAPO manufacturer who will need to differentiate themselves in pricing as well as functionality. Apart from pan-European directives, national regulations play an important role. Introduction of ISO regulations will add another layer of complexity to this. Therefore, staying ahead of legislative requirements will be critical for manufacturers to make sure they have the best fit products in each market. Improving comfort is a common challenge across most respiratory protection product segments. Hence, manufacturers who are focused on this particular aspect in terms of product design will see increasing customer acceptance. Emergence of ISO standards by 2020 is expected to positively impact the dynamics in the respiratory protection market. For instance, fit testing mandates could increase the cost of these masks, but the rise would be gradual. According to the firefighting industry, voice communication and decontamination are the two key areas that SCBA manufacturers will need to focus on in the future. With the new PPE directives, private label products and Asian imports will need to make sure their products meet compliance standards. Otherwise, they will risk to lose their presence in the market. Most Western European countries are witnessing an uptick in both their manufacturing as well as construction industry. And this is expected to contribute a big way to the growth in respiratory protective equipment such as disposable masks, PAPO during the forecast period. What do you think? On that note, I hope you have enjoyed this session. Please join us for future podcasts and become a member of Frost & Sullivan's Leadership Council by emailing us at digital@frost.com. Thank you for your time and have a nice day.